Hi, welcome back to the show. Well, as promised, we're going to talk to the management of Tata Power. The losses at the Mundra project have expanded in the fourth quarter, but one-offs actually boosted the profits. The company's newly appointed CEO, Praveer Sinha, joins us now in his first television interview after taking over. Mr. Sinha, thank you so much for joining us here on the show. I just want to start by, with your comment on the discussion that we were having before the break with the other two gentlemen. 59 gigawatts worth of power projects are currently under stress now. What do you see as the fate of these power projects? Any buyers, big haircuts that banks would have to take?
Well, it depends what sort of. First of all, thank you very much for having me on your show. And this is the first interview that I'm giving after taking over. What we see is that many of these power plants do not have full PPAs or do not have fuel supply. So those are really challenges, because until and unless you have a PPA which ensures a take or pay obligation, people would be averse to looking at these projects. And I think it's important that some of these projects have PPAs tied up. They also get the fuel supply tied up, and then only they become viable for anyone to look at them seriously.
Some of these plants will perhaps come, as Mr. Mundra was saying, and I think Khurana, they may come with 50%, 60%, 70% loan haircuts. Will Tata Power be a buyer if you got it that cheap?
Well, we look at many of these investment opportunities, and we always keep on scanning the market if there are good opportunities. But as I mentioned to you, we are definitely looking at those projects which have full PPA tied up.
Okay.
And have.
But those are not coming to the NCLT, Mr. Sinha.
So
what is coming are 20,000 megawatts without PPA. But if the loan is completely knocked down to 30% of current, would that still be an attractive proposition?
We also look at what sort of tariff those projects will have.
Okay.
And where those plants are located, what sort of technology they have. So there are large number of filters that we put on them, whether they are environment friendly, sustainable in the long run, what capacity of those units are.
You sound like an interested buyer.
Yeah, we definitely look at all investment opportunities if it comes, but definitely the merit of the case determines whether we will look at them seriously and go forward.
Okay, Mr. Sinha, good morning. So, what's the way forward now for Mundra? Because, one thought after Gujarat polls, perhaps that outcome would be out. Nothing out on that yet, that shutdown or selling it back. Your thoughts on that?
Well, when we have a project, we look at it from multi dimensions. We do not look at it that it has only one solution. So there are certain things that we keep on doing internally in terms of how do you reduce the operational cost, how do you reduce the financing cost. So some of those aspects we are looking. We are also talking to the government and see that today the plant produces at 80%, because if we produce more, we lose more money. So is there an opportunity for us to produce more quantum of power, and the additional quantity gets sold at the market rate so that we do not have a hit on them. So that's an option that we are looking. There are other ancillary services that we can do. So what I can tell you is there are a number of options that we are looking with the government. And while some of them we will do internally and optimize our cost, the rest of them we need the concurrence of the buyers of power, the five distribution companies.
But the losses have gone up this quarter. So can we expect that to continue over the next few quarters?
Well, the losses is dependent on the cost of coal. So it's the variable cost which goes up.
Yeah.
And what we have seen in last 1 year that the coal cost have been going up. And that's the reason the losses went up. But we expect that the coal prices will come down over a long period of time, especially considering that world over coal-based plants are shutting down. In Europe, many of the plants are shutting down. In Germany, 2022, all the coal-based plants will be shut down. So also in US. So there is definitely an opportunity that the coal prices will come down because the demand of coal will reduce. And I look at an opportunity whereby we will be able to reduce the cost of production and to that extent reduce the losses.
So putting together all the operating efficiencies that you have planned, and going by the demand, because merchant power rates are going up, looking at the short-term increases in merchant rates, for FY19, what do you think is the likely operating loss in Mundra, and what is the likely EBITDA for the entire Tata Power projects?
At this stage, I don't have the numbers of the likely losses or will be
directionally deposited.
But we definitely expect that it will reduce over a period of time because of the internal efforts that is being made. Mm-hmm. And I think all these benefits will accrue in terms of the loss reduction that will happen.
How do you plan to reduce the losses at Mundra? I mean, what are the steps that you're taking?
As I mentioned to you, that we are looking at optimizing our O&M cost, optimizing the financing cost, maybe get an opportunity to sell the additional power at a market price. So some of these are still work in progress. So at this stage, it is a little premature to give any direction. But yes, I'm expecting that it will reduce. We also keep on looking at different qualities of coal, do blending of coal to a large extent, so that and also keep on buying coal from other sources apart from Indonesia. So there is definitely a game plan, and we are working on all those areas simultaneously to see that there is a reduction in the losses in the coming years.
How much of your money comes from defense, and therefore what is the revenue loss because of the defense business that you have sold to your group companies?
Well, the defense business as such was a very small business on the total of Tata Power balance sheet. And that business was not giving us this type of synergy that is required with Tata Power business. And that's why we thought that it would be proper that in the group, one of the companies which has focus on defense business, we move this business so that they have scale and they are able to meet the requirement of the market.
But how much has it helped you delever?
Over a period of time, we'll get something like 2,000 crores.
Okay.
But this is linked to certain orders coming over, and those aspects have to be taken care of.
And what about other non-core assets? Anything else that you can sell?
We have already sold Tata Communication, the Panaton investment, and that is there. We also keep on looking at some of the other non-core activities that we have.
Like what?
Like we have a stake in Nelco, or we have a stake in Tata Projects. So these are opportunities we keep on looking at. At the right time, we will take a call whether we would like to divest or we would like to continue, depending upon how they perform and what sort of returns we get as a promoter.
What about the renewables business? I mean, little more on growth there. Were there any kind of investments planned? What are the PLFs?
Renewables is a focus area for us, and we are looking at expanding in renewable space, especially in solar. The PLFs have been good in last 2 years. We have seen that it has gone to about 21%, and we expect that as we move forward with the new technology coming in, we'll be able to do further improvement in the PLFs and also in the returns in renewable business. So that's a core area that Tata Power is looking at, and I'm sure in the years to come we will become the biggest player in
What's your total debt now, and how much might it be at the end of FY19?
Well, in terms of the total non-coal business that we have, it's about 3,200 megawatt, out of which solar is about 2,200. So these are numbers that we need.
I meant debt, sir. What is your total loan?
Sorry.
And how much is it now, and how much will it be at the end of the current fiscal?
We are about 47,000-48,000. And we expect that with the deleveraging that we are doing, especially selling of the non-core assets and some of the other receivables that we are expecting from our investment, we should be in the range of about 40,000 to 42,000 megawatt crores.
Okay, Mr. Sinha, it was a pleasure talking to you. Thanks a lot for your time, and all the best for next quarters.
Thank you for dropping by in our studios.
Thank you very much. Really appreciate it. And we'll catch up again.
Sure. Okay.
That's Tata Power, of course. The market, well, it's cooled off from the high point of the morning. Of course, the mid caps are in a bit of a bother, but no problem for ICICI Bank. That's still up about 6%. BEML is the other one ahead of the Karnataka election. That one has been surging 5.5% higher, is what we have on that stock. Ashwini Gujarat and Rajat Bose back with us. Ashwini, you had taken a shot on the bank.